As a remote pilot in command, should we be creating a maintenance schedule? Hey everyone, Jason Schappert here of remotepilot101.com, and the answer is truly yes. We should be working to create a maintenance schedule, but don't take it from me. Let's dig a little bit further on what the FAA has to say in Part 107 regarding documentation. And this is, again, straight from the FAA. Careful record keeping can be highly beneficial for small unmanned aircraft systems owners and operators. For example, record keeping provides essential safety support for commercial operators who may experience rapidly accumulated flight operational hours and cycles. You're flying a lot is what it's saying. Consider maintaining a hard copy and/or electronic logbook of all periodic inspections, maintenance, preventative maintenance, repairs, and alterations performed on your small unmanned aircraft system here. So let's take that even a step further now. They tell us to document it. Document it how? Well, we should document any repair, modification, overhaul, or replacement of a system component resulting from normal flight operations. Record the time and service for that component at the time of the maintenance procedure and assess these records over time to establish reliable maintenance schedule for the small unmanned aircraft system and its components. Every 50 hours, I change the props. Every 100 hours on a battery, I disregard that battery and I purchase a new battery. You have to create this maintenance schedule. We're in an expensive hobby as it is, right? But as commercial operators, it's important to operate above and beyond when it comes to this. This is no longer just a hobby. We need to operate as a commercial operator. So whether you make just a notebook with your maintenance of what you do, you make a nice Excel spreadsheet, it doesn't matter. I recommend your number one, logging your flight time. I flew here, I did this. It was with battery number one. Whatever it may be, as detailed as you'd like to be, and then detail the maintenance you've done. Think about it. Imagine when you go to sell whichever drone you're using right now one day, because you're going to want to upgrade to the bigger and better drones as they come out, right? Imagine the person buying that, you could go to them and say, hey, here's all the maintenance records of everything I've done to maintain this appropriately, showing you operate really above and beyond. We do this in manned aviation. Our engine, our airframes all have logbooks that go with them to show that we're keeping up with our maintenance. So when we sell an airplane, they can know that the airplane was well maintained. What the FAA is saying here is we should be doing the same with our drones. It goes a step further, though. We're thinking from a legal standpoint. Forbid there was an insurance claim. There was even worse, a lawsuit. We have documentation to prove that we operate above the bar, and here's how we do it. Here's how often I do it. Here's when I did it. Here's my entire maintenance record. Here's my entire flight record. You can see I'm a good pilot who's always learning. You can see I'm a good pilot who's always maintaining my drone. And we can then prove that. Whether you do it with a notebook or you do an Excel spreadsheet, it doesn't matter. They're just saying, please do something is what they're asking for. Listen, I hope Remote Pilot 101 has just been an excellent just asset to you in your journey, whether it's your initial test or you all know we have the new recurrent course out, which is free to you all if you're already a lifetime customer. Doing something cool next week, September 27th, I'll be live actually doing a practice recurrent recertification quiz, sharing with you actual questions and of course their correct answers and why. That'll be live on Facebook and live on YouTube, on the Remote Pilot 101 Facebook and YouTube. So subscribe to us on YouTube, like us on Facebook so you get those alerts. Those events are already scheduled on there too, so you can make a calendar invite for yourself, as well as we're still giving away that Mavic Pro 2. remotepilot101.com/Mavic to get signed up for that. No strings attached, not gonna spam you or anything. October 1st, we're giving it away live on Facebook and on YouTube so you can watch. You don't have to be present to win, but it'll be fun to kind of be there with everybody. And of course, a ton of great other prizes will be given away as well. My point of this, go ahead and make some of those maintenance records, start logging your flights, and I'll see you on some of the upcoming live streams. Remote Pilot 101 is the most successful Part 107 test prep course on the market with over 18,000 tests passed. It's one price and you get our updated initial and brand new recurrent course for life. It's two courses for the price of one, and it's for life. See the actual test questions, learn the material, take the practice quizzes, all at your own pace through our easy videos you've already grown to love. Visit remotepilot101.com to become a member for life and learn more.